EDG are one of the most cursed teams in league history. They've lost again and again and again.
EDG has never passed the quarterfinal barrier before, and this is their best chance.
Gala is alone. That's an easy smite. The flash is followed with the dunk, and Gala is gonna get sniped by Viper.
Second time around. Alone. Can they keep him away? It's at 2K. They can burn this down. They find the first bit of CC. Oh, who claims it? He gets the Baron anyway. Does it happen again? Will we get another Baron steal?
Oh, it does again!
We do again and again. Jungle Diff is the name of the game, and it's going to be Wei saying, you know what? Take me. Cause I'm coming for you. It took them 6 attempts, but this time they will knock down RNG. This time, EDG won it all. This team, EDG, are headed to the semifinals.
Smites have gone Clint's way, and they will yet again. He still doesn't miss. The TP comes in to take the fight. The dunk comes in. Clint won't find the kill just yet, and it's a swoop in. That's a one, but the slicing maelstrom turns it back. 3 kills so far. Kennen gonna make it a 4th, and look at that. EDG get the team fight they want, and Ruler sees his kingdom fall to ashes. He's got no turrets left, he's got no life left, and he's got no road left. The world championship, Viper puts in a couple of shots. BDD is going to die and die, and the Nexus falls, and EDG, the last of the LPL, are headed to their first world final.
I still think that if I had to bet my life on it, I would pick Dom1.
I want to say 3-0 Dom1.
I think Dom1 probably takes it as well.
I just think what we've seen from EDG will be dismantled by Dom1.
Mako goes in, pops immediately like a balloon, but Canyon going to follow suit. Flandre gets exhausted, and Khan now trying to continue this fight. Some low health bars as the flash comes forward. Khan goes golden. Viper is still alive, though. Flashes in. Showmaker down to 200. He's a sitting duck. In order to close this one out right here, there is one turret between EDG and history right now as Viper dashes forward. Showmaker goes golden, but it's not going to keep him alive. Mako is going to be the sacrificial lamb, but it's a double kill already for Flandre. Lightning rushing his way out of this one, and now the Nexus is exposed. Dom1 Kia are limping, and EDG have the man advantage. The Nexus will go down, and against all odds, EDG will be your 2021 world champion.
All right, folks, before we get into the video, I just wanted to let you know that we've teamed up with our friends over at Predator Gaming to bring you a holiday gift guide. You're gonna hear from all of our hosts about what we want this holiday season and maybe give you some ideas of what to ask for yourself. All right, here's Liz.
Ho, ho, hello, everyone. As the lovely Daniel Rosen just explained, we've partnered with our friends over at Predator Gaming to give you a lovely holiday gift guide. You'll get to know us hosts a little bit better and find out what we're all looking for this holiday season, and maybe you'll get some gift ideas for yourself and be the best gift giver there ever was. Which I'm not saying you aren't already, but we all could use a little polish and sparkle. So grab some hot cocoa, eggnog, whatever your poison is, and let's get started. So you guys may have noticed I always wear earrings in my videos. I don't really wear any other jewelry, so I carry my earrings really, really carefully. That's why these earrings from Tiffany are gorgeous. They are the definition of a classic. You can dress them up and you can dress them down, and that's why they're on my wish list. Now, y'all know I love Valorant and I'm a Killjoy main, but I'm actually trying to spread my wings and become just as knowledgeable on Astra. Learning a new agent takes time, and that's where the Predator Triton 500 SE is going to be my savior, because I won't miss a day of grinding just because I'm on the go. Personally, this gift would mean a lot to me because it can handle my work as well as my play. It's convenient, has a cool backlit 3-zone RGB keyboard, and with an Intel 11th Gen H series Core i7 processor, I'm not going to be sacrificing any performance compared to my desktop. You can check out this Predator laptop at your local Best Buy. You can check me out at my local coffee shop grinding some Valorant on this machine. And I drink lattes with 3 Splendas if you wanna like talk or anything like that. Anyways, if you guys have seen my videos, you guys can hear people speaking from a speaker, just not a very good one. So since I don't have room for speakers, I was looking into sound bars and I came across the Sound Blaster Katana V2. Aesthetically, it matches my setup, and most importantly, it can fit under the riser that I have. So basically now, I'll have no excuse not to hear sound cues. That's my holiday wish list. Now let's get back to the story.
Thanks, Liz. All right, so Edward Gaming are the winningest team in LPL history. But despite all their domestic success, for years, they've had one big problem. They always choked at Worlds. See, EDG had a curse. Every single year they made it to Worlds, they got eliminated in the quarterfinals.
He wants to run down Maul. Death, his brother in arms, will be his dead man in arms. That's a triple. Huni finds Clear Love in the back, and Reckless with the rest of Fnatic. They're on to the Nexus, and Fnatic will advance to the semi-finals.
Well, except for 2017 when they drowned in groups.
But it doesn't even matter. Edward Gaming came so close, and they looked so good, and they were almost that third team in. But it is SK Telecom T1 with another comeback win, 5-1.
In 2018, EDG got sent packing by Fnatic 3-1 in, of course, the quarterfinals. And with longtime jungler Clearlove heading into retirement, the team promoted JJ from their academy roster in April 2019. But the next few years were even worse. EDG failed to qualify for Worlds 2 years in a row. The once legendary roster was now a shell of its former self, and they had to make some changes. The team brought in Flandre first. Flandre was considered one of the LPL's best top laners, but playing for crappy teams for most of his career tarnished his reputation. No matter how well he played, the results were always disappointing. But their next signing was the big one, Viper.
When will they find it? What's the play? Forward they go. They might have knocked him down. Puts down the pool, but is there enough damage? They're going to try. They ult over the top, but it's already a 2-0. Viper doesn't die, but one finally comes through. It's up to Jackie Love, but he gets stunned. Clutch from Tarzan, but Morgana can't find it either. Viper stays alive. That's the full pentakill when they needed it most.
If you don't remember Griffin, they were a once promising team that was torn apart by Scandal. But amidst all the controversy, Viper was one of the team's shining stars. He was an insane player with incredible potential, and while his 2020 was rocky, fans hoped that combining him with Mako in the bot lane would bring EDG back to their former glory.
It felt like for both of these bot lane players, this was a fresh start almost, where Mako gets another attempt at being the support for a superstar mechanical AD carry, and Viper gets a fresh look at trying to make it to the World Championship.
There were a lot of question marks surrounding EDG. No one was really sure what to expect after years of mediocrity, but on paper, this roster looked terrifying. And once the spring split finally got underway, Viper and the rest of EDG showed that they were there to play.
They're gonna try and commit to this one on top of the dragon. They get in, but they do not get the dragon. That's third Drake here for EDG as the fight ensues. The rest of EDG trying to just keep themselves alive. It is Bubi who falls, but they trade it for JJ. Massive three-man knockoff. It's a quadra kill out of nowhere for Viper, and they're gonna try and gift him over to the Penta. They are going to give him over to him. Viper gets himself a Penta kill.
Viper managed to win MVP in his first split in the LPL. But despite EDG's regular season performance, they lost steam in the playoffs. They were eliminated after back-to-back 3-2 losses to FPX and RNG, and they were forced to watch from the sidelines as their rivals lifted the MSI trophy. After taking those playoffs losses, EDG bounced back for the summer. They started to split off with a 7-series win streak and entered the playoffs as the second seed once again. But if EDG wanted to live up to the potential their fans knew they had, they'd have to perform in the playoffs this time. The chance for redemption was there. They just couldn't choke again. Unfortunately, in their first playoffs match against the 7th seed Team WE, it looked like the old EDG was back.
Will have vision on the Baron. Flandre up on the top side, but no slicing Maelstrom here. Elk will be able to poke. Breathe can move into the pit. Baishunk has flash available. Needs to try and look for the steal. Into the pit, and he gets it as well. Viper still surviving, still has his GA. Elder getting low here. There is no jungler for WE. The smite will... No!
Oh, he gets
Elk
it!
Elk steals it! The perfect play from Elk and Shaq spawns to kill onto Mako and WE. They win the impossible fight 3v5.
Some crucial missed smites cost EDG to sub out JJ for the remainder of the series. They went on to win the next two games, but fell short in game 5 and got sent down to the loser's bracket. The catastrophic misplays didn't stop EDG from giving JJ another chance, though. he bounced back and helped his team claw their way to the grand finals. But on the other side of the rift, their opponents were FPX. FPX finished the summer season as the best team in China. But in the grand finals, EDG proved that they were the region's best.
Tian playing this one safe. Baron will reset. FPX actually going onto the Baron themselves. There's the shockwave. Straight onto Flandre. Shuts him out of the fight. LDBX caught up. And Scout takes over. The rune's coming up strong. And now EDG in control of the fight. Doom B flashed upon as Scout gets the triple. Gets the quadra. And gets EDG the Baron.
Scout is a monster.
They're retreating to the wrong side of the map at this point. Flandre about to turn Mega. Keep your eyes on him. Tien goes for the 1v1. Hero's entrance in to try and protect the jungler as well. Doom B on the back line. In comes Flandre, but the stopwatch has come on through. Flandre with a huge Gnar ultimate. Maybe this is it. But FBX still firing out.
Viper!
In goes Viper! Turning no! it around! No!
What? How does Viper do it? How does he manage the triple kill at the most crucial point of the game?
And the fact that he's playing so aggressively, using the Gale Force to go in. We've seen it all series long. Viper is afraid of no one.
Off the back of a series-defining play from Viper, EDG won their first LPL title since 2017. But Worlds was still ahead of them, and their curse loomed large. Then again, their incredible performance in the summer made some people believe that EDG could go all the way.
So for EDG, I think being in good form, you know, knowing where they stand, knowing what they're good at, and being able to come into the tournament in that kind of strong position, I think they're the kind of team that can really maintain that momentum and maintain that strength going into a tournament.
While EDG were among the favorites, everyone knew that only one team could truly be considered gods going into Worlds. Damwon. The defending world champions dominated their group and qualified for the bracket stage without dropping a single game. And while Damwon impressed, some of the Chinese teams kinda choked. FPX and LNG failed to even make it out of groups, and surprise losses to T1 and 100 Thieves meant that EDG entered the quarterfinals as the second seed out of Group B. This set them up for a match against their regional rivals, RNG. Essentially, hopes weren't high for Chinese teams. Especially not EDG. Sure, they were still China's number one seed, but that group stage was really shaky. And they still had that quarterfinals curse to deal with. If EDG were going to make it to the semis, they'd have to take down RNG and break their curse at the same time. And the series didn't exactly start well for them.
RNG 14-8 in kills, looking at a 30-minute victory, a slaughter against their countrymen here as EDG, their base will fall, a best of five begins, and the first game goes handily to RNG. They won the lanes, they won the map, they handed over almost nothing in a 30-minute game one victory over EDG.
But it was a back and forth series, and it went all the way to game five. It was now or never. EDG had to break the curse, or exit the tournament in shame.
And even taking up some of these jungle camps. Wow.
Oh, spotted. Gala is alone. That's an easy smite. The flash is followed with the dunk, and Gala is gonna get sniped by Viper. Liquid Gaming, their first ever World Championship semifinal on the line, and they are winning in the climactic game five.
And you can see how EDG are doing this. You have Flandre push out top, go and cover mid, Scout immediately going down towards bot side, and the play's coming out.
Okay, TP's coming in. There's the first knockup. Gala trying to kite. He's rooted, and he's gonna drop. Bullet time hits two waves. A 2-0 so far. Xiaohu not gonna find anything as the shockwave hits nothing at all. And here comes Yuumi healing up Scout. Will he die? The heal's in yet again. Thank you, Moonstone Renewer, and they do not have the damage. It's three unanswered, it's four unanswered. One man left alive crying as RNG's hopes at a world title fall. EDG, it took them six attempts, but this time they will knock down RNG. This time, EDG won it all. This team, EDG, are headed to the semifinals.
It wasn't easy, but EDG got the job done. Their five-game thriller against RNG sent them to the semifinals against Gen G. Meanwhile, Damwon swept Mad Lions out of the tournament on the other side of the bracket. EDG's shaky performance made them into the underdogs now, and there were a lot of questions about how far they could go.
Like, going into the semifinal specifically, I was really confident EDG would win that one. But I was not confident that it was like, these guys are the favorite for the tournament, these guys are gonna make it forth, these guys are gonna, you know, finish things off and take the crown. So going into that semi, for me, it was like, we need to see something good here. We need to see these guys destroy Gen G.
The semifinals between EDG and Gen G was a nail biter. It was back and forth for the first two games, but Gen G took game three and EDG were once again staring down elimination. And with their backs against the wall, EDG pulled through again.
But they just want to stall here for Flandre to get as much damage on top side as he can. His teleport is ready, his flash is ready.
All right, but he's just autoing the turret right now, so what's the call going to be, EDG? If you keep playing this one, you can be outnumbered. You already are. It's 5v4. Keep them health on the dragon. Smites have gone Clid's way, and they will yet again. He still doesn't miss. The TP comes in to take the fight. The dunk comes in. Clid won't find the kill just yet, and it's a swoop in. That's a one, but the slicing maelstrom turns it back. Three kills so far. Kennen gonna make it a fourth, and look at that. EDG get the team fight they want, and Ruler sees his kingdom fall to ashes. He's got no turrets left. He's got no life left, and he's got no road left. The world championship, Viper puts in a couple of shots. BDD is going to die and die, and the Nexus falls, and EDG, the last of the LPL, are headed to their first world final.
EDG managed to come back and win the series to book themselves a spot in the grand finals, but it wasn't easy. And after two back-to-back five-game series in what many considered the easier side of the bracket, nobody thought they had what it took to beat Damwon in the finals. In fact, to most League fans, the real final had already been played between Damwon and T1 in the semis. Damwon won that, and now the tournament looked free for them. But EDG had nothing to lose. They were the underdog, sure, but their curse was broken. They'd gone further than they ever had before at Worlds. And when they hit the stage for their clash against the defending champions, they shocked everyone.
Perhaps it will not be enough. The five band of EDG looking to go in.
Flash Cataclysm comes forward and JJ just trying to put them in position, but it's Canyon. He's got the ultimate, and now the dive forward from Beryl. It does not work out. The grand entrance only hits one, and then he just pops like a balloon. The wind wall looks comically ineffective as now the Nexus turrets are falling. And for a series that so many predicted was a 3-0, yes, it might be, but it's not going to be for Damwon Gear. Edward Gaming absolutely wiping the floor with our former world champions. They make sure they finish the job before they finish off the Nexus.
Damwon wiped the floor with EDG in game two, and although game three was closer, the LPL team still didn't seem to have an answer to the Korean dominance. But EDG had been here before. If anyone knew how to play from behind after this tournament, it was them. So in game four, they took the fight to Damwon.
And Brute Force taking the tower and picking up the extra kill. EDG, oh, bubble lands here, actually.
Yeah, this could be the pickoff. The minion wave turns up in the nick of time, but Ghost could be the one to go down, and he absolutely is. The Heartbreaker comes in, but now JJ in a bit of trouble. He just gets himself over the wall. Canyon explodes as well as Nami is turned into a fish finger. Showmaker now at about no health as Khan's doing his very best to be the hero, but it's not going to happen this game. As Damwon Gear are routed once again, they're running the wrong direction, and EDG should be taking this game. In fact, Flandre, he's taking inhibitors himself.
Rumors of the LPL's demise have been greatly exaggerated at Worlds this year, my friends. EDG will just put a stomp down on game number four. Push us to Silver Scrapes, push us to that game five, Alice.
EDG bounced back. They managed to snowball their early lead and close the game out to take the series to game five. But they weren't done yet.
Find the Kennen early, throw down the pillar just to make or delay that engage and force him to use some...
Showmaker.
Yeah, he's so far forward, has to flash out. The scan of the weak is good, but it's not good enough. The slicing maelstrom comes in, and now Khan trying to take down Canyon. There's the collateral damage, finally. He gets it done, and he's not done yet. JJ taking a lot of damage. Khan will fall down. Ghost is still alive, doing a fair bit of work, but Beryl, he's in the middle of four people, and EDG will wipe them off the map. It's just a lonely Ziggs, and EDG have full control.
It's Damwon Kia. They're still biding their time.
They
waiting
for
their opportunity
is.
As Mako goes in, pops immediately like a Balloon Canyon, going to follow. Suflandre gets exhausted, and Khan now trying to continue this fight. Some low health bars as the flash comes forward. Khan goes golden. Viper is still alive, though. Flashes in. Showmaker down to 200. He's a sitting duck, and it's a double kill for Scout. Now he's flashing forward, picking up all of the summoner spells, and it is good night for Ghost and an ace for EDG.
Well, Mega Inferno Bomb's going to try and deny it, but look at the Baron protecting these minions so, so well. The Ziggs, the wave clear doesn't really work, and now that's a teamfight tool that they're missing as well. Moonlight Vigil going to connect onto Ghost fantastically, but he does satchel his way out. Still, it's just going to be creating space to take down these inhibitor turrets and inhibitors. The mid lane going to go down as well as EDG will crush the base of Damwon Kia. Do they have it in them in order to close this one out right here? There is one turret between EDG and history right now as Viper dashes forward. Showmaker goes golden, but it's not going to keep him alive. Mako is going to be the sacrificial lamb, but it's a double kill already for Flandre. Lightning rushing his way out of this one, and now the Nexus is exposed. Damwon Kia are limping, and EDG have the man advantage. The Nexus will go down, and against all odds, EDG will be your 2021 World Champions.
They've done it! They've actually done it! The LPL is back on top. Fedius, combo breaker on Damwon's attempt for the back-to-back titles. So much prestige there. All the EDG had to do was break their world's curse as soon as they got through the quarterfinals.
EDG pulled off one of the biggest upsets in League of Legends history to hoist their first ever Summoner's Cup. But they didn't just beat any team. They beat Damwon, a team that some fans had already called a dynasty before the tournament was even over.
I know in my experience of Twitter replies, there's a lot of LCK fans that will discount those two previous finals. Well, this one cannot be discounted. This one cannot be disproved. EDG was outright the best team at that tournament. LPL was the best region at the tournament, and that is an undisputable fact.
EDG are now the undisputed best team in the world. Their win over Damwon capped off an incredible year. And going into 2022, they're the team to watch out for.
1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 3. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 3. I jump back to that blue sky.